This one, I have some affinity for, which is the Rockefeller family.
Yeah.
It's David Rockefeller, whom we knew somewhat.
Yes.
Wonderful man, a real legend, justifiably so. Third generation, right, grandson of John D. Rockefeller. And his father actually helped put together this enormous, incredible art collection. We have to remember, they founded the Museum of Modern Art by taking some of their, his father gave a bunch of art to the Museum of Modern Art. That's where it came from. But this is what's left over.
And some of that, I was at the MoMA recently, and some of that art is actually going back to the MoMA. Some of the Rockefeller collection is going back.
Oh, is it really?
There's some really nice pieces there. So $646 million in the first round, above, you know, what they expected. And, you know, this is some very special art.
Oh.
Matisse, Monet, Christie's is handling this. Yeah, one interesting thing.
This is the Picasso.
That's right.
Of the young woman nude,
right,
which actually hung in their library. I've seen video of this in their library.
Oh,
they're just sort of hanging on the wall.
I just, whatever. It's there.
And I love this quote that's at the end of the story, because it talks about, as you alluded to, Rockefellers are as close to we have as sort of American royalty. You know, I actually live up in Westchester County and live adjacent to, you know, the area that they really created and lived in, and many of the, you know, Rockefellers still live there. They
and business royalty.
Land. Yes.
Business royalty. The combination of royalty and business.
Right.
I mean, if you go
and
back,
philanthropy.
And philanthropy. Exactly right.
I wonder, do we have a breakdown on who wound up buying? I'm just curious to see how much U.S. money versus how much foreign money was in
it. We don't have a clear idea yet. I think, you know, as the auction, because as you said at the top, there are several more chunks of this auction to happen. I think we'll get a good sense. You know, one of the interesting quotes at the end of the story is, it mentions this idea of American royalty. It also says, if you're a new collector, it's great validation because it was owned by this, you know, amazing, this amazing family. And if you're an old collector, you sort of think it's cool that, you know, you've got a piece that the Rockefellers would
have. And where's the money going?
Right.
All the philanthropy, all to the causes that they had.
That's nice.
Every dime of it is going to philanthropic organizations. They designated 12 of them that it's going to, including the Council on Foreign Relations, actually.
And I do think about, you know, I think we talk about this a lot, this notion of, you know, what happens to the next generation of these types of business titans, you know, the Schwartzmans, the Kravises, and whatnot. Do they follow this same model as they collect? And, you know, we look down the line. So it's an interesting sort of arc to watch.
It's a great story.